are there ways to live to, and I don't put a limit. You see where it says 120 plus. The oldest female on the planet that, according to recorded history, lived, Jean Calumet, to 122 years of age. And she wasn't even a person who understood anything about augmenting hormones, you know, a healthier diet per se, although prior generations, I tend to believe, ate a little bit more whole natural foods than we do at this time. And you think about some of the limitations, but on the other hand, that means that within your genetics alone, you are programmed to be able to live past, easily past 100 plus. It's something along the way that sometimes people make conscious decisions. And don't get me wrong, you know, you get to a certain place and you go, well, I just don't feel like living beyond a certain point. And we've all had parents or grandparents where we've seen they lose that will for life, that drive and the excitement, and they're just ready for their time, and God has decided, and that's their time. And I understand that. But I also believe that in the case of when I remember my 92-year-old grandmother, when she had fallen and they decided that, you know, she was really challenged and she was in a care facility and she had an injured hip, and you know, she was crying and she was saying, I just want to pass on. I'm done. You know, she said, Nikki, I just can't take this anymore. And so I conferred with the family. I said, is it okay if we intervene and we introduce her to bioidentical hormones, to the concept of certain things that restore the telomeres, certain natural ways to reduce inflammation? How can we restore her fitness? Introduce her to certain novel ways to stimulate the lymphatics, reduce a little bit of the fat, not just on the body externally, but in the bloodstream, and help her to reach a state of happiness and a focus, and really regain that feeling of love, enjoy the intake of super whole natural foods and enzymes, and overcome most of the diseases that most of our seniors, if not even our teenagers now, already are developing. And the family agreed with me. They said, yes, help Grandma Muller, help her out. And they knew, you know, I've been in this field for a long time. So I went about and I tested her hormone levels, which were extremely low. And I found out certain things that we needed to do. And we started by training the staff to rub these natural hormone creams on her skin. We have a current cream now we call Stem Cell Max. Do we have it here with us today? Stem Cell Max, you rub it in the skin, and it restores DHEA and pregnenolone. And we were spraying in her mouth growth hormone, Grow Young is what it's called. We had the early forerunner of certain plant-based products, Slim Blends and protein powders and Stem Cell Strong. And now we've perfected a lot more since in those days. But I just remember that after about a month, she was up out of her hospital bed and she was able to return home. And she was, she hired a personal trainer, and we would come and take her out in the front yard, out in the daylight, because you need daylight, you need sun to stimulate the body, you need fresh air, you need activity. And, you know, he would teach her to lift her legs really high and, you know, get it above the grass, and, you know, just because, you know, that was part of her exercise. And each day he was working with her. And I came over one day and she said, oh, wow. She said, this is really tough work, Nikki. He makes me work hard. She calls me Nikki, right? You know, I'm Nick, right? And she looks at me, she goes, you know what? I am feeling better. This is really amazing. And she goes, and man, is he sexy. I said, Grandma, you know, 92, Grandma. I mean, you know, the hormones were kicking in. She was starting to come to life. She was remembering, you know, those that great loving feelings and energy that we all experience and have. And sometimes it's a glance, it's a look, it's a way it's said. But, you know, the most precious thing that happened for me with my grandmother was the fact that the grandchildren and the family was able to enjoy some precious additional years with her. Where, remember, when I first came to her, she had given up. She was crying. She said, I'm done. I don't want to live any longer. And my grandfather had died several years prior when he was a mechanic. He was very successful. He came from another country and he built his whole business from the ground up and had a very successful, ended up buying apartment buildings on his property and in LA. And you know, he was quite very sharp. I loved my grandfather. And I just remember one day he said, The doctor told me that just like the plumbing in a house, we have to redo your plumbing and your prostate. And I'm listening to this. I was younger, you know, and he was telling me this about this situation. And well, they're just going to do some surgery and they'll fix it all up. You know, and there's this belief that we can just somehow go in there and with a surgeon's scalpel, right, or some kind of a drug or some kind of a chemotherapy or radiation, just fix the things that maybe could be lifestyle or diet related or inactivity or toxin related or whatever. And I just remember after he had that surgery, he was never the same. He ended up having infections related to the surgery. He declined rather rapidly, and I lost my grandfather. And I thought about that. I thought, you know, I wonder if someone had understood what the chief problem is with hormones and how men develop prostate cancer. And we now know it's more related to low estrogen levels, that is high estrogen levels concentrated in the prostate, and some other factors related to an animal-based diet, and also low testosterone levels. Quite the opposite of what most urologists believe prostate problems are related to. They'll even give men suppressive drugs to suppress their testosterone. They'll actually go through a whole process of giving them estrogen therapy. And yet this has been done wrongly, according to some of the top experts now, including Dr. Morgenthaler from Harvard, who's written a book about testosterone for life. And I truly believe that not just men will benefit from restoring bioidentical hormones such as testosterone, but it can change the course of inflammatory diseases and certain hormone-related conditions. Do you know now for women, one of the chief forms of therapy for breast cancer is testosterone therapy? They put women on testosterone therapy either by creams or by pellets that are embedded into the skin. And sure enough, it's the most potent anti-cancerous substance because it builds up your own immune system. What a novel belief. What if you could just simply understand that things as simply as garlic, things as simple as medicinal mushrooms, that are rich in beta-glucans, and now the clinical studies are starting to verify that what we've known for more than 30 years that I've been doing this research, that truly most of these chronic diseases have an origin and an issue with either depressed immune system that we can support through proper hormones and supplements and good eating and exercise and outdoors in the daylight. You know, the first thing that you look at is when you want to understand a disease is you don't analyze the disease from a standpoint of what drug, surgery, or chemical. And the one message I want to leave with you is there might be something very natural that God had decided a long time ago that these diseases should have never existed. And they tend to come about, and if you look through generations and other societies that still live, some societies still live rather a primitive lifestyle. I say primitive from the standpoint of eating whole natural foods, still exercising, still maintaining that outdoor activity like in Okinawa where the longest lived people are, literally. They certainly, I mean, there's, if you go to one of our website blogs, you'll see pictures of people climbing up trees to get oranges off the trees. And I mean, and we're talking 90-year-olds and 98-year-olds going up trees and, you know, being physically able to climb up a tree, okay, let alone to be active enough and then to enjoy the whole fresh fruit that's right from that live plant. So we in society have to understand that rather than focusing on what this disease is, and I'm perfectly okay with you seeing a medical doctor or an alternative practitioner, hopefully you'll merge the concepts and start to understand that, sure, you might have a diagnosis or a disease of some kind, but even that label itself denotes that there's only one course of therapy that's appropriate in our, quote, society. And I would like you to recognize that there's a whole world beyond that. There's textbooks written about this. There's literature that shows the reversal, or maybe rather accurately, because I don't want to use the word cure or change or getting rid of a disease per se, but just the restoration to a more natural state that's a healthy state that we were all born to be for our entire life to the last breath we take at 125. And if that's really true, then each one of you, it is worth your time to invest a little bit of time, knowledge, and energy, and to go beyond what maybe you've been led to believe is the reality of health and fitness, and consider that the future of health begins at the cellular and the chromosome level. telomeres can be lengthened. They can actually, and there's evidence, prolonged life in animal studies, and then there's substantial prospective studies and other studies around that is related to cultures around the world, where I believe the concept of stay young, and you look at the chromosomes and the pairs of the chromosomes, and we see at the end these little bright areas. These are the telomeres. This is the site at which every time the telomeres, when they divide and form into new cells and send the genetic information of how they need to be another brain cell, while they already were a brain cell and now they've replicated into additional nerve cells or tissue or organ or intestinal. But when these telomeres shorten with each replication, there's a limiting factor. There's a factor of how many times they'll replicate. So current science has it that in people who have shortened telomeres, either due to aging or premature aging or certain lifestyle factors, when we introduce certain plant enzymes that are rich in telomerase, which has been found in Aspergillus, and it's been found in the activity of nutrients like L-carnosine and certain amino acids that stimulate growth hormone, and these different combinations of therapies have been proven in animals to allow them to live sometimes twice as long as their normal original intention, like in the case of the dog Rex. They literally live twice as long than they otherwise would have in dog years, or in worm years, or in snail years, or whatever animal they're studying. So that's a pretty cool thing. The only thing is, you can't just run around and say, here, I have a product I created, it's called Stay Young. Here, you take some tablets every day. You take some tablets, you take some tablets, you take some tablets. But you all there, you don't get to take them. And we're going to just sit back, and 120 years from now, we're going to just compare each other. And we're going to say, since I'm going to take all these products, because I'm not going to take it a chance, I'm going to take them. Because even if I invest the money and I say, well, you spent a little more money than you did because you guys didn't use the products, but I did. I spent a little more money. I could have spent it on extravagant things. I could have spent it on anything that was a foolish investment. I like to think that my body's worth investing in because it's the only one I was given that I know of. And I kind of like my body. I like being in it. It's not that I sit there and I like admire it, like, oh, this is really cool. You know, it's not like that. It's like, this is nice being in here. I can only tell you what it'd be like if you were inside my body. That'd be like a scary experience. Like, whoa, is that what he feels like all the time? That's like, I have to hold myself back. I kid you not, I feel so good. And then I have people, they tell me, oh, you know, it's a struggle just to get up in the morning. I don't know how I get through life. And I have to drink coffee all day. And I can barely sleep at night. And I mean, I hear the stories every day. And I think to myself, they only have to step back a little bit. And I just say this because, you know, if we believe, if we believe that we can alter the course of your future, which starts now. I mean, you can choose. So the half that decides to move forward, they're the proactive people. They're always the ones that step up in the front of the line and says, hey, or they sit up in the front row or in the back row, it doesn't matter. But they take the information and they do something with that information. The two probably in my lifetime, most positive people I've ever met in my life. And I don't mean just positive on stage or on the camera and so forth, but I'm talking behind closed doors after everything's done and it's been a late, long day and a late, long month or week and whatever. And just talking to them and knowing and being associated or friends with these individuals has just been a great inspiration for me. Jack LaLanne, Bob Delmatique, who just passed on, I was at his funeral yesterday, and Bob Whelan, who's still with the living and is right now approaching Washington, D.C., a double amputee with no legs, past the age of 65, pedaling his bicycle with his arms because he has no legs. And he's going across the entire nation. He started here in Orange County. I watched him, helped him to get take off on the launch up in Los Angeles, Pasadena. So, you know, when you say, look, boy, I have trouble getting to work and doing all these things, taking care of my kids and managing my funds. And, you know, we all have only a certain number of hours in the day. I mean, hey, you know, I'm right there too. But when I sit next to Bob Whelan, my friend, and he tells me, you know, my wife needed these things, so I had to stop at the store. I had to pick this up and this up and this up before I was biking on to my next training session. And I'm thinking to myself, the guy's got no legs. He's got to maneuver his handicapped van. He's got to get out, get his wheelchair out. You know, wheel up into the store, locate this thing for her, you know. And this is a good husband. This guy's been married to her for I don't know how many years, since as long as I've known him. I mean, he's been my friend for over 30 years. And I talk about this only to say that we are more than just our physical being, aren't we? We're very, very much our spirit. And our spirit, whether it be Jack O'Lane still lives with me, and Bob Del Matique lives with us, and my dear friend, Bob Whelan. So I look at that and I think, you know, what do I need to do to inspire my children or the audiences that hear me to speak? Because, you know, it's for me, it's up to me to leave with you something that you'll remember, because I've been speaking for 30 years and I remember talking at audiences, and people have come up, literally 30 years ago, I was in LA and I had a gentleman come up and he said, I heard you speak 30 years ago. He showed me his lab work. He said, look it, I used to have high cholesterol. I was scheduled for heart bypass surgery. He said, you know, the doctor said I had glaucoma. I was gonna lose my eyesight. He said, look, it's 30 years later since you taught me this program. 30 years ago, I bicycled from Whittier, California to downtown LA at the JW Marriott. I mean, let alone he got through traffic. I don't know how he did that. I mean, that's a little scary riding your bike in downtown LA. But the point is, here's a guy in his 70s, right? Physically in great shape, never needed the bypass surgery. Now, I never told him don't have the surgery, but I said, look, if you get your body into a healthy state, it might be that your body will figure out a way to improve circulation, to clear up these plaques, and to restore your body to an optimum state. That's all I shared with him. I taught him everything I knew of how to live in an optimum state. So much so that at that anti-aging conference, doctors from all over the world came to hear me speak, and I was training about blood morphology and technology. And even as recent as 2 months ago, which I was director of the entire Nathan Pritikin Better Health Program. How many of you here, have any of you heard of the Pritikin program from years back? Okay. And some of you heard of Dean Ornish. He came along a little after, a cardiologist who was able to prove in medical journals with studies, as did Pritikin, that you could clearly, through diet and exercise and natural supplements, reverse cardiovascular disease without drugs or surgery. And so much so that literally this last month, I didn't think I'd ever live long enough to see it, although I know I'm going to live a long time, Medicare has finally approved the programs I helped to create 30 years ago in weekly classes of lifestyle education. In place of, or as a decision in conjunction with your drugs or surgery, or those who chose not to go down the drug and surgery route, but to literally do it naturally and restore the body to a state that it was intended to be. And I personally am so excited about that, because it brings validation on all the tens of thousands of people that have heard me speak. I had people come up and call me up and say, you know, Dr. Nick, I, you know, it's really great to hear your voice, because I used to hear your father on radio 30 years ago talking on KBRT, Christian Radio, KKLA, and KIV. I mean, every night, drive time from 6 to 6:30, I'd hear your father speaking about the excitement about health and fitness and nutrition and how to stay young and healthy. And you were on weekend talk show Saturday, and we used to call in and ask questions to your father. I said, that wasn't my father. I said, it was me. I've been doing this for 30 years. I just look young, but that's what I've been doing. I'm committed to, because 60 years from now, when you come hear me speak and you go, hey, I used to listen to you 60 years ago and you started me off, and hopefully I'll touch you close enough to get you excited about why sexy people live longer. I study monkeys. I like animals. Monkeys are really cool. Monkeys have a certain kind of pecking order in a society where the bonobos monkeys are known as the love monkeys. And in their society, they have a certain order of when they eat and who's the dominant monkey. And it's interesting about that. But we, a group of men, there I was, and an American bodybuilder, a gentleman from Malaysia, and some guys from Australia. And we bought some bananas. We were told, buy the bananas before we go in the rainforest, because that's what you're going to feed the monkeys, and you'll get to pet them and talk to them. I don't know about talk to them, but pet them. Be careful. They could bite you, they said, and everything. So we got the bananas. We walked into the forest, and we started feeding the little monkeys bananas. And the female monkeys came out, and they started eating, the little baby monkeys. Then out of nowhere, the dominant alpha male monkey would come right through the bushes. You'd see the bushes part, and I mean, a big monkey come running out. And I mean, he went right around the food, the other monkey skipped the other men and came right at me with his claws, and he was angry and trying to bite into me. And I'm like, oh, I turn and I run. The monkey's behind me, and I have the bananas. I'm thinking, okay, he's hungry. Throw the banana behind me. He didn't want the banana. He skipped the banana, kept chasing me till I was out of the range of the area of his dominant territory. And this happened once, and I thought, that's strange. And why didn't he try to chase the other men, and what's the deal? So I, you know, kept walking through the forest, and as I kept walking, another monkey comes darting right from the other side, and I get the gig. I know, hey, I'm in trouble, because it's not going after the other guys, it's going after me. I turn and I run as fast as I can, and it happened no less than 6 times in the forest. And I'm like, this is amazing. What is going on? Well, you know, you can see my musculature. I take herbs and supplements, so I have a high level of natural testosterone. I was considered by the monkeys the alpha male of the human group. And even though the American bodybuilder was hyped up on synthetic hormones, the monkeys couldn't detect it. They didn't consider him the alpha male. They considered me. And so all you have to do when you go into a laboratory, if your man or you as an individual female have low testosterone levels, just get a monkey, sit up next to you. And if he gets a little riled up, then you know you have a pretty good testosterone level. If the monkey ignores you, your levels are depressed. So it's really interesting, but Avena sativa, nettles, and certain herbs, Tribulus terrestris, release natural testosterone into your general tissues and circulation. They keep you younger. It's been known for years, for thousands of years, that certain plants, when they talked about astragalus, which helps the telomeres, they said, eat this plant and you will live longer. Now, I don't know what generation or how they figured it out, but they just noticed people who ate those plants lived longer. I mean, old Charlie, he was still alive and everyone else had died off, and old Charlie's still alive and he's on to the next generation. I mean, I hope to live long enough to sire enough children to have so many generations that they all, you know, live long. And then, you know, we just start this whole generation of long-lived people because, you know, living healthy and happy. I mean, in this society, I mean, we tend to revere athletes, right? And it's usually those athletes with the highest testosterone. I mean, you could picture them all. It's quite obvious. And a number of the athletes, remember I told you earlier the story about giving power and speed to racehorses. Well, we've had a number of top athletes use these products and notice an incredible increase in their mental acuity, their strength, their endurance, and their speed, which is very appropriate for athletics. And the nucleotide or nitrogenous base, which is a very natural source of energy, all I have to do is caution you. First, the first time you take it, don't take it at night. Take it in the morning. Take it before you work out. Take it before you're going to do something more intense, because power and speed is called extreme energy. It's not your normal little 6-hour little liquid drink with caffeine. It is like intense, intense, dominant energy. So sometimes you want to have a little edge. But I would also caution you, take a half a tablet, because we're talking explosive. And I've had people say, oh, it can't be that much. They'll take 2, right at the beginning, 2 or 3. And I'm like, oh, you didn't do that, did you? I was in Texas, and I was at an anti-aging conference, and a couple comes up to me, and you know, they were clearly a couple and they were married, and he goes, oh, I don't know what to do. I've got so much energy. I said, wow. He said, I took 3 power and speed. I said, well, what would you do that for? I said, I told you to take 1. He said, well, I just wanted to see what it was like. Well, I said, well, why'd you take 3? He says, well, I don't know, but I don't know what to do now. What do I do? I said, well, go with your wife up to the room and go have sex, burn it off. And then go work out, and then come back, and you'll probably be okay. And I said, make sure you hydrate, though, because you have that much energy. You better have a lot of fluid in your body. He says, okay. He disappears. I forget all about him. I'm talking to people, the event, conference. They, you know, come. Then he couple comes up, walks up, and he goes, wow, it really worked. And he's talking too fast. And I'm thinking, okay, so what's the deal, dude? He goes, well, yeah, it really worked. It burned off. I had sex. We had sex. It was great. It was incredible. And I worked out, and that helped. It burned it off, and I took more. I go, what? You took more? I said, what are you doing? He says, well, this is amazing. I've never had so much energy in my whole life. And I said, I could tell. You're talking so fast. I'd be like, geez, slow down, man. Go up to the room, have sex, and go work out again. Just burn it off, okay? Or do something with it. I don't know. Build a building. You know, create a dynasty. Create your business. You can figure out things to do with your energy, can't you? I mean, there's a lot of things. You don't have to just depend on caffeine and synthetic drugs and chemicals. and look forward to a future of substances that are abnormal. So natural bioidentical hormones are not synthetic. You see, in chemical pharmaceuticals, they want to patent chemicals so they can control the budget on them and basically, you know, have you prescribed, you know, through a doctor's office and so forth. And then, but they're unnatural. They have side effects. They're not adopted to the body. The overdose side effects, acne, extreme behavior, excess need for sex. There's nothing wrong with wanting sex, but, you know, there's a point where some of the synthetic chemicals versus the natural, actually the sex part gets really good. It's actually better than with the synthetics, by the way. But it's natural to the body, and the bioidentical hormones, which in the stem cell max cream, the DHEA, the pregnenolone, if our doctor decides that some of the men who are so deficient in testosterone, they'll prescribe little testosterone pellets, and they insert them under the skin. And women sometimes get a few pellets. They don't need as many. Men take about 10 to 20 pellets. Women take one or two. But let me tell you, it's like this immediate, almost I say immediate, within a few weeks, you just start noticing you have more bounce to your step, you have more energy, you have more strength, you build muscle better, cellulite starts melting away, and you think this is better than a television commercial that promises everything on the list. Well, it works, it really does, because it clinically works, because the tissues are stimulated by what? Your tissues follow directions. The chromosomes, the tissues, the telomeres, the replication, the directions of your body. It's like having a roadmap and your body being directed exactly what to do, like the master computer. And what's the master computer? It's the endocrine system, the pineal gland. It's each of the hormones from the hypothalamus that are released all the way from growth hormone to the adrenals, which is DHEA and adrenaline and cortisol, to the thyroid, which is a master gland for metabolic levels and controlling your body weight, onto the testes for testosterone for men and women, ovaries for obviously estrogen and progesterone and other very important hormones. So there's an infomercial that's produced. I was on a talk show, and it's going to air in January. It's going to go across the country. And so you'll see, I've been at this for 30 years, and I went away from the media for quite a while I was doing research and development creation. And now you'll see a lot of shows out where I'll be appearing on different talk shows and different things. And so, you know, just send people to the website, get our free newsletter, and understand and learn how products like Testrovita, which I created as far back as 1996, I was doing research on the herbs that contributed to the current day product we call Testrovita. This is one of the most amazing products. This is the one that I used to consume, not in the name called Testrovita, but the herbs that were within it, that when I went in the rainforest and the monkeys got all riled up. And you know what? It not only happened in Indonesia. When I went to the monkey forest in India, same thing. The monkeys got very angry. They would growl at me, get angry. They were nice to everyone else, but when I came near them, it was like, whoa, this guy's got, we better challenge his testosterone levels, you know. So the fun thing is that you can exert the biological activity of what's called free testosterone by releasing it from a binding protein. The binding protein increases in women who either are on oral birth control pills. They have too much binding protein, so it renders a lot of your hormones ineffective. It increases with age. It's in a form of estrogen called estrone, and sex hormone binding globulin. As it increases, it makes it in your body unable to get the necessary amount of endocrine hormones to get the tissues affected to remain young and healthy and youthful. So I figured this out and went through the literature and the research. It was clearly present, and we actually tested people. And here's what we found: individuals who had a testosterone level of less than 1.3, it increased 28-fold, 28 in less than 3 weeks by taking the herbs that are currently in Testrovita. This individual had a testosterone of 344 in October of 94. The level after less than a 2-year period went up to 860, nearly double. So it's not always necessary to have a prescription for, say, testosterone. And some people don't want to take certain natural hormones. They're concerned, or they just don't understand their actions. So I created a whole line of products that, with their herb action, Testrovita, along with a product called Modulate and Stay Young. Within that, there are certain herbs that are concentrated at 200 to 1 in some of the cases, like in the case of Longjack, and all that means is that I've created pharmaceutical grade quality products that are very potent natural herbs that used consistently and repetitively restore youthful levels. And if that's what you, something you want, these are just some women I've noticed, recognized. I've seen these people around. She was pretty sexy in her day, right? Still very sexy. I think she's now in her 70s or so. But you know what? We all define quality or I mean, it's interesting. You take five people and you say, look, which one's the sexiest looking? Universally as a society, we all tend to have the same concept. But that's where plastic surgery came in. It says, okay, well, all we have to do is make this, this, and this, and change the lips, and, you know, change the hair, and this, and that, and then, you know, make a uniform look. I don't think that's what sex is about. I think attraction and energy. There's been studies where they put people where they were divided by a glass, and so they couldn't smell each other, couldn't taste them. And they came into the room, and they looked at the other person. They were asked to write on a journal, what do you think when you see that other person? So the man would write down something in the journal note, and just whatever first comes to your mind. And the lady would write down something when she'd see the individual. And it was interesting, because in some of the people, they said, when I saw that person, it was love at first sight. I don't know, I've never seen the person, I don't even know who they are. Something triggered in my body, and all I just felt this overwhelming feeling of love. And that's how chemistry is, isn't it? When you're attracted to someone, it's like a chemistry, and it always is the same with that same person. And then some people you're not attracted to. Why, we don't know. And there's something, probably pheromones, there's something at a level, but it did penetrate through glass. So it has something to do with what you see in that individual, and a chemical release is called PEA, phenylethylalanine. And it's like when you eat chocolate, it's the same chemical, but it's way more concentrated than chocolate. We're talking hundreds of times more concentrated. So how they proved it was when they wrote down in the journal, love at first sight, those people, they really wanted to see what changed in terms of their hormone levels. And they measured this huge increase in PEA released from the brain. So the point is that, you know, we are attracted, and that's a good, attractions, laws of attraction and energy, whether it be a sexual attraction or a sensual attraction or just a business attraction, or I like that person, I don't know why. And you know, with NLP and timeline therapy, you can create attractions with people in a phenomenal way that can motivate your sales, motivate your team, motivate people to do things they would have never done before in terms of their own limiting beliefs and abilities. So on Saturday, December 17th, when I come back from the biggest anti-aging conference in the world, and I'll be speaking at that conference, and I'll be talking with doctors and lecturing and moderating and introducing people and showing them about the Delgado Protocol products and so forth. Right after, when I come back on Saturday, December 17th, at our office in Costa Mesa, we have a small facility upstairs for a meeting area about this size, and we'll have about 20, 25 people. And I think it's $19 for a couple and $15 for a single individual. And we're going to be doing timeline therapy, NLP, neurolinguistic programming. We're going to program, but unlike other classes you've ever heard about, I'm going to help you to instill the highest value of health that you have to make this a reality, so that 30 to 60 years from now, you'll be practicing things that you probably thought, I could have never lost that weight, I could have never got rid of those pains, I probably would have had surgery or not. But it's a question about what we instill at the deepest level of belief. And when you have that burning desire and that unconscious belief that you will accomplish, like my friend Bob Delmatique always told me, he said, Nick, I see you doing it. You absolutely, sincerely have to believe from the deepest in your heart. And I'm going to help you show you how to float up above your limiting beliefs, release them out, literally out into the space, and substitute in a new, much more powerful, empowering thoughts and concepts and beliefs, so you will accomplish things that you never thought possible. So without going into details about sex and intimacy and so forth, you know, the power of the mind and energy and stem cell max and so forth, these are products that I've created over the years. But the point is that in this class of timeline therapy, I'm going to show you how to use these products, how to improve your diet, how to bring fitness and exercise in a fun way into your life. The reason I'm a world champion is that I don't go out and do workouts that are really tiring and boring to me and think. I do an amazing set of workouts that I do in 30 minutes to an hour, and I can train with the best athletes in the world and keep up with them, even though I'm twice their age. And they go, you know, they see me show up in London in the world competition, say, hey, you're here to watch your son compete, because my son competes. My son's a big strapping 240-pound, you know, 5'11". You know, I'm a little guy. I show up and they say, hey, old man, you're here to watch your son compete. I said, no, I'm here to beat you. They said, well, you're in the competition? Are you kidding? You're small. How old are you too, by the way? And I said, oh, we'll see. We'll see. Let's see how it goes. And then I get up there with 45-pound dumbbells in London, hammer curl press, to the point where I led Team USA to the World Championships with my buddy Tim Nash, who's a big strapping genetic phenomena, and my son, who's big physically and, you know, dominant. And we beat the World Championships. And so I don't put limits on what I know I can do. If I want to accomplish something in life and in health and in fitness, and I want to create and perfect the ultimate products, the products that you would be proud to allow your children to use. So when my little three-year-old, when he comes in the morning, he says, Daddy, Daddy, my vitamin. I know exactly which one he wants. He wants the Modulate little tablets, like a little chewable, kind of reminds a lot of the other adults of the Flintstone vitamins. I guess they have a similar taste or something. And he chews on them and he just loves them. He says, Daddy, the vitamins. Every morning he comes up. I didn't tell him to do this. He hunts me down and literally says, Daddy, I want my vitamins. Now, I give him the other bottles of Estroblock and other things that, you know, he really doesn't need. And he goes, no, that one. I said, that one? He says, that one. I open it up. He's happy as peach. So it's safe for three-year-olds. I mean, it's a product that stimulates and releases your own energy, your own hormones, your own feeling. And this is just to show a product or a picture of people with deficient estrogen levels, excessive estrogen levels, and just right. And the diets that we see in the analyzed through estrogen metabolism, as we age, there's a problem. There's a decline in the healthy, good estrogens and an increase in the harmful forms of estrogen that either come from pesticides, from what's called xenoestrogens, and they're chemicals that need to be detoxified out of your body. In fact, when people start using our products, Estroblock and Stay Young, and that combination, for example, it helps to detoxify. You even see the urine change color as some of these chemicals are leaving your body. I mean, this is toxic substances that retain in your tissues for a long time until you drain them out. So they're all natural. They're coming from organic cabbage, broccoli, certain things that remove these harmful estrogens. So you can see the result of dominant harmful forms of estrogens in the body profile of women and in men. And they look years older than they are, and it causes premature aging. Now, in some cases, you know, you have a more sleek body type, but then you can have too low of estrogen levels. And so I'm not advocating we obliterate or get rid of all estrogens. I'm not even saying that all estrogens are bad. I'm actually saying there's 40 different estrogen metabolites. We've studied the science to make it clear there are ways to restore the good forms of estrogens and create that shapely, healthy, youthful body and help to reduce the retention of abnormal fat metabolism that happens in so many individuals. And it's just like with men. I mean, you say, well, there's studies on castration, and the men have zero testosterone, and the damage with this, with actually where they had surgical castration, they lose their bone density, they develop Dowager's hump, they develop breast tissue, fatty breast tissue. Now they still have a head of hair usually because, you know, estrogen doesn't counterbalance hair growth and so forth. So, you know, I said, well, wouldn't it be great if you could restore the testosterone levels and still maintain healthy hair growth and nails? So there's a product, I don't know, do we have it here, Tim? The black container bottle it's called Grow. It's Grow. Beverly, it's probably in the car. Jessica, did you remember we brought it in? It's some here, yeah. Dr. Hausman had created and developed it. We'll probably have it to show you later. But it's funny because I started taking this product and I'm like, I kid you not, I'm like, I mean, my dad has thick, full of hair, but on my other grandfather's side, on my mom's side, you know, he was bald. His uncle, my other uncle, was bald, and so, you know, that thin hair kind of thing is very common to my genetics. I know that to be the case, and I started taking this product, and in less than a few months, the vitamin D levels are a special natural mushroom extract that's so potent. My fingernails, I can't even keep up with clipping them often enough. My hair grew in. I've had four haircuts in the last like 2 months, and it's like really unheard of for me. I mean, my hair doesn't normally grow that fast, and it'll never be, you know, thick and, you know, rich and like that. But it's also a sign that my hormones are balancing and adjusting and things are healthier. So I would never want to have this situation on a regular basis, but sometimes it's appropriate. And when it's appropriate, you know, we tend to, us as men, enjoy this type of situation because it's a very pleasurable, natural thing. I once was on a talk show, and in the back of my book, it had a listing. It said a healthy male who has good hormonal balance will have at least, and there was a typo on the back, that it was supposed to say at least 10 erections a night. And it's not necessarily related to sex. It's just, you know, the penis inflates and deflates, and it's just normal 10 times a night. And there's ways to measure that and all this. And the typo, when they produced the copy, it said 100 erections a night. So I got these crazy, like Howard Stern's type calling me up because it was on a TV, an interview report. So they were calling experts and says, okay, so Dr. Delgado, you're having 100 erections a night? And I'm like, well, not quite. That wasn't the point I was trying to make, okay? But, you know, men, when the time comes, when they want to have intimacy and enjoy sex, and by the way, women have clitoral erections too. So the organ may look smaller on the exterior, but women have a far more extensive organ, nerve, tissue, and circulatory system that's far larger than any male, you know, penis or organ. And that same type of philosophy with the product called Omori, and it's called Omori for a reason, because it helps to clear an enzyme that interferes with the nitric oxide filling of the tissues of the genitalia. So it really does have a profound difference on your love life. And I just think that couples who have intimacy on a regular basis are enjoying the quality of life. They live longer. There's a lot of evidence that they do. And you know, even the British Journal 1997 and Life magazine published Queen's University that they tracked 1,000 middle-aged men over a 10-year period. Those who had orgasms at least twice a week or more had half as many heart attacks. And that's in a published study. So there is evidence now. And you know, whether the whole process of orgasms and sex increases testosterone, which by the way, those men with the higher testosterone levels have lower natural cholesterol levels or healthier balance of HDL to LDL. And so there's probably good clinical evidence for maintaining this. So longevity secrets, if you look in Okinawa and the cultures around the world and in Bama, China, Okinawa's off north of Japan, and then China, there's areas of what's called Bama, China. And you look at these people over 100 years of age and they have certain things in common. You know, they practice fitness, they're still playing golf or out in the field, still exercising. They largely consume a vegetable-based diet. And, you know, years ago, I remember I never used the word vegetarian. It just wasn't appropriate because it was like saying communism. It's like, oh, you're a vegetarian, are you? And they get this thing like you're some kind of scrawny, weak, you know, gray skin, pale type person. I'm like, I go, okay, so I won't call it that. I won't even say vegan because that's, you know, total absence of dairy and meat and no cheese, no eggs, no fish. And well, then what do you eat? Well, there's a whole array of great things you get to eat. And so when I take my children out to eat, they're eating this wonderful, marvelous variety of whole natural foods. But the point is, I always use the word superfoods or complex carbohydrates or high fiber, natural, low fat foods. And sure enough, in the American Chiropractic Journal, just a few months ago, they published a study. And these people, it was reported, had ankylosis spondylosis. And it's a very severe form of arthritis. And they say it's genetic. Well, in a German study, they actually took a whole group of people who had supposedly this genetic disease that the doctor said was incurable, and they put them all on a, quote, vegan diet. Oh my gosh, a vegan diet. And so, but listen what they did. It was vegan, low fat. Because some vegan diets are high in fat. They use a lot of oils and stuff. So this was a low-fat vegan diet, and it was gluten-free. So they were smart enough to remove the allergens, reduce the fats, still give the benefits of all the fiber, whole natural foods, a wide variety, and guess what? The cure rate, and they even use that word, the cure. The cure rate of these individuals with a genetic disorder of a severe form of genetic arthritis was nearly 100%. Literally. The joints cleared up. In fact, in another journal, Lancet, which is a very well-known medical journal, there was a study where a whole group of people had inflammatory rheumatoid arthritis, which, by the way, the incidence of arthritis is out of control. I wrote a book that's here called Stay Young, and we have a shipment coming in next week. We have a few copies, but we can ship you books if you want. And this book, for $19.95, and it's on Amazon Kindle. You know, you can download it because I'm a big fan of Kindle, and you can now listen to these books. But it goes through the history how individuals were on dairy product, and they actually had people with severe arthritis, and they said off all dairy product, and they took them off for 2 months, and the rheumatoid arthritis cleared up. They then gave the individuals the equivalent of 1 teaspoon of milk that you would put in coffee, 1 teaspoon, and within 48 hours, all the symptoms of severe inflammatory rheumatoid arthritis came back into their body, complete body racked in pain. So when you underestimate the power of a very sophisticated advanced diet that's designed the way our human physiology, the way we were intended to be for our entire life, and if you underestimate the power of certain herbs, herbal medicine is, I mean, it's thousands of years old. And yet, see, the pharmaceutical company wants to make it look like, oh, come on, how can these herbs make any difference? I mean, take our drugs. The drugs are the way to go. Just take the drugs. Don't worry about the side effects. Have you ever watched on television when they're saying the list of side effects? And then they lose their hair, they lose their sex drive, and they have diarrhea, and they're vomiting. And by the way, you maybe go blind and maybe tell your doctor if you have these symptoms. You're going, what? But they held these people all happy and joyful, and they're all excited, they're on these drugs, and they're just, they look the peak of health, young and happy. I'm confused. They're sending me mixed messages. They're telling me, oh, people who are healthy and happy and alive take drugs. Their doctors tell them take drugs. Might as well just go find the street drug seller and go take crack and cocaine and heroin and just get all, just load it up. Or you might just consider, you know, doing a natural thing and just going back to herbal medicine the way it was designed to take care. The herbalists knew, they knew what herbs worked. And this is written about thousands of years. We've known this. This is not, oh yeah, that's experimental. Nick, you spent 30 years figuring out what should be in each of the products and coming up with these formulas to help people to reverse the ravages of aging. But oh, we don't know. There's, you know, you haven't studied more than, you know, 1,000. We've had thousands of people take the products. We have doctors all over the country, all over the world using these products now. And so the fact that you don't see it in GNC and you don't see it in Walgreens and okay, you just wait. When my infomercials break, then, you know, then they'll be saying, oh yeah, where is this Dr. Delgado's products? We want to get them. So you're in the beginning of it. You're finding out how natural high hormone levels as you age. You can see the difference in people 100 years old have higher natural testosterone and estrogen and DHA levels than individuals 30 years younger in our culture at age 70. Well, why do you think they live longer? Is it because they have more sex and they have higher hormone levels, or they have higher hormone levels and they can have more sex? Who cares which it is?